for the word of God.
Amen. Thank you, Reverend. Amen. We thank you, Lord Father, for once again bringing us before your throne of grace to be fed with your
Amen. Words.
We thank you, Father, for this grace. We thank you for the privilege we have to be counted among the few
Amen.
That these mysteries of the kingdom of heaven have been revealed to you.
Amen.
Father, as we come with our hearts, open our hearts to you, Lord, be seated, Father, to consecrate your message. I know the plan that I will deliver it to, Lord. We see the Father to open our hearts to understand. Give us that knowledge, Father Almighty, that we so much need. Let us be able to move forward. Let us understand that this is, O Lord, and let them keep them in our hearts, that they will not depart from us, O Lord.
Amen.
At the end of this message, let each and every one of us have every cause to glorify your holy name.
Amen.
And never let our lives be the same again.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, Father, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated. As you see this morning, the theme for this message, show me your ways, O Lord. Teach me your paths. Lead me your truth. And teach me. For you are the God of my salvation.
Yep.
On you I wait all the day.
Amen.
You may be wondering, what kind of message is this? Is it a prayer, supplication, or a sermon? It's so pregnant with so many meanings.
Amen.
That this morning, we shall be unloading them one by one.
Wow.
Show me thy ways. The psalmist wishes to know God.
Amen.
He wants to know God's way, to be taught his path, and to be led into his truth. He cannot descend this way unless God show it.
Amen.
He cannot learn the path unless God teach it.
Hallelujah.
And he cannot walk in God's truth unless God leads him.
Yep.
And even then, unless God continues to teach, he shall never fully learn the lessons of his salvation.
Amen.
Therefore, he adds, lead me in thy truth and teach me. As we read in Psalm 25:5, that he may get this showing, teaching, and leading, he comes to God as God of his salvation. And that he may not lose his labor, he waits on him all the day. Many lose the benefit of their earnest prayers. Why? Because they do not persevere in them. They pray for a time. They get remiss or discouraged. They restrain prayer and thus they lose all that was already in store for them. Sometimes they say they quit when the harvest is about to come. The Lord said in John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Many oftentimes, believers and people who want to belong to Christ so they could enter into the kingdom of heaven, but they are not actually committing themselves to do the wishes of Christ. So they found it difficult to know how it could be the way. Even his disciples who had lived with him found it difficult to understand him. Today, we are asking ourselves, like the rich young man in Mark 10:17-25, good teacher, what shall we do to inherit eternal life? I believe his answer to us will not be different from the answer that he gave to that young man, to follow and obey the commandments. Do not murder. Do not commit adultery. Do not steal. Do not bear false witness. Do not defraud. Honor your father and mother.
Amen. Hallelujah.
But the young man assured Jesus that he had kept all these things from his youth. So the young man passed the first test. And how many of us here today can even scale through the first ladder of our effort to be with Christ in his kingdom? Do not murder. But the Lord went on to qualify what God meant by this commandment, as we read in Matthew 5, 21 to 22. You have heard that it was said to those of the old, you shall not murder. And whoever murders will be liable to judgment. But I say to you, that everyone who is angry with his brother will be liable to judgment. Whoever insults his brother will be liable to the council. And whoever says, you fool, will be liable to the hell of fire. And as long as the teeth and the tongue also do fight, and they reconcile, and agree to work together to achieve their common goal, so should we, children of God, never allow our anger to last once we have been reconciled. Yeah. If you continue to have a grudge or have enmity against your fellow brother or sister, then you are gradually on your way out of eternal life in Amen. Christ Jesus. Amen. Amen. Do not commit adultery. The Lord also said in the same Matthew 5, 28 to 30, you have heard that it was said, you shall not commit adultery. But I say to you, that everyone who looks at a woman with lustful intent has already committed adultery with her in his heart. Amen. But if your right eye causes you to sin, tear it out and throw it away. For it is better that you lose one of your members than that your whole body be thrown into hell. And if your right hand causes you to sin, cut it off and throw it away. For it is better that you lose one of your members than that your whole body go into hell. I suppose this warning goes for both men and women. Some women purposely dress to kill so they could be noticed. God created beauty after all to be admired. I don't laugh. Hence, a beautiful woman to be admired and complimented, but not to let that compliment develop into daydreams. In all cases, we all need prayers. And follow Apostle Paul's advice to both married men and bachelors, as we read in 1 Corinthians 7, 7 to 9. Yet, I wish that all men were even as I am myself. However, each man has his own gift from God, one in this manner and another in that. But I say to the unmarried and to the widows that it is good for them if they remain even as I. But if they do not have self-control, let them marry, for it is better to marry than to burn with passion. Looking at him, Jesus felt a love for him and said to him, one thing you lack, go and sell all you possess and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven, and come follow me. But at these words, he was saddened, and he went away grieving, for he was one who owned much property. Are we really different from this young man? Even though we are not as rich as he was, and yet in our poor state of need, we still find it difficult to believe that he is truly the way and the truth, which to the best of my understanding should be enough a reason for us to see God while we may still have the opportunity, so that we can also have life, which he claimed, I am the life. It is very discouraging that despite all our efforts and words of exhortation, I'm pleading to you, especially leaders, to get closer to Christ, to take advantage of the resources made available free to you via our Bible study, where you are sure to improve your knowledge of the words of God and faith. You still refuse to understand that tomorrow is not promised anybody. The question that should be pondering your heart is, when God says it is time to go home, my child, what work will he find in your hand? Are you ready to follow Jesus?
Hallelujah.
I am the way and the truth and the life. It's one of the seven I am statements of Jesus. On the last night before his betrayal and death,